Hello, my friend.
Hi, Danny, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Oh, yeah, good surviving. Well, no, I'm actually doing pretty good. I'm enjoying spending time with the family and working one job instead of two. And it's awesome just to hang out with the girls and get lots of sleep. And I've stopped eating too much now, put myself on a diet and tried to reduce the alcohol intake. But it was fun for a while.
So just tell me, for anyone that might not know who you are, tell me your name, your work history, and where you currently work.
Okay. So I'm Sean Lorenzi. I am I'm the medical director of Flawless Rejuvenation Skin Clinics, and I'm also a full-time emergency physician at the Alfred Hospital in Melbourne. So, I kind of get the best of both worlds.
How's the emergency?
Look, from a presentation standpoint, we're actually down about 40%, 30 to 40% of presentations, because there just aren't the people out there doing stupid stuff and getting sick. So we're, from an emergency perspective, we're quiet, but we've obviously been planning for the COVID-19 medical response. So we've upgraded the hospital, we've trained, we've upgraded the emergency department, we've managed to claim back some space in the hospital. We've increased our ICU beds from, I think it was around 50 to 60 to 340 beds if we need to, and upgrade the emergency department from, I think, sort of 40, 50 spaces to 200, over 200 spaces if we need them. So we can expand into those should we get hit with a COVID response that requires what we're seeing in New York or the UK at the moment. But fingers crossed, what we've done as a nation, we're not gonna see that kind of an increase. We hope, fingers crossed. But you know, Singapore thought the same thing, and now they're in a bit of trouble.
The last time I saw you was at Kateri University, and you were telling me that you were about to go to New York. I bet you count your blessings now.
Yeah, exactly. I was supposed to be in New York just when it went crazy. So it was never going to happen. The flight was always going to be cancelled. But yeah, I was supposed to be leave for New York within 5 days of Kateri University. Oh.
So the flawless rejuvenation side of things,
what yeah.
on earth made you move into aesthetic medicine?
It's fun. I kind of just fell into it by taking a course in Botox and filler, and just kind of fell in love with that. And that kind of snowballed into me opening up my own practice, doing just injectables, and then it frustrates me when I can't do something. So if someone says, oh, I've got this lentigo, or I've got my skin textures a bit off, or I need some skincare, to be sending them somewhere else was crazy. So we kind of expanded our services, and we've grown into the company we are today, which is kind of a full service facial and body aesthetic business. And yeah, it's fun. And the other thing is, you know, emergency medicine, it's great. I mean, I do love it, but it's really hard on you physically and mentally. And I turned 50 this year, so I'm not the spring chicken anymore. And look, it's a hard job, and I don't see myself being able to continue at the pace I'm continuing in the next few years. So cosmetic medicine's a great way to kind of balance that and give me another headspace so that I can have longevity in both emergency medicine and the cosmetic sphere.
What are you most looking forward to when the COVID-19 restrictions are lifted?
Seeing my friends, having a drink with my friends, having a meal, and hugging them and being with my friends, because you know, they're all, lots of them are business owners, and lots of them are going through exactly what we're going through here. And you can't, you know, you can support them over the phone, but sometimes, you know, you just need a big hug or something and say, look, we'll get through this together, and support. So yeah, I'm missing my friends and contact with them. Not crazy stuff, just maybe a dinner party would be great.
Me too, just human contact. I want to see someone else other than me. Oh, don't get me wrong, this is lovely, right? And I'm enjoying seeing you and enjoying having a coffee with you, but there's nothing like human contact, is there?
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, it's really strange. I went out to get some lunch today, and I bumped into a friend of mine who, when I normally see her, would give each other a big hug and say, how are you going? And we kind of just stood 1.5 meters away from each other, really awkwardly, you know, shuffling our feet, going, oh, yeah, hi, how are you? Oh, that's good. Look, can't wait for this to be over, kind of thing. So it's just a strange interaction. It's not normal.
Yeah, it's bizarre, isn't it?
You're the same as me. You like to kind of hug people and just not being able to do that. Just, it's awful.
Yeah. It's awful. First couple of weeks I was loving it, being home, because you know how much I travel. But I'm totally over it now. And you've seen my Facebook and my Instagram, and all I'm doing is cooking.
Cooking, and it looks great. But yeah, look, I'm enjoying being home with the girls. It's awesome. Yeah. I've spent a lot of time with them, and we watched movies and played games, and I'm there. I'm home 6 nights a week for dinner, which is unheard of for me. I don't normally get home till 7 or 8, and I'm there when they wake up and they do school, and we do family stuff. So it's, you know, I have to enjoy the bits I can out of this isolation, because I don't think it's going to last too much longer. But yeah, look, it's awesome to be home and be a proper dad. And
that's lovely. Well, you said then you don't think it's going to last too much longer. So I've seen some emails today about, you know, clinics reopening next week and getting back to, you know, services.
I think we need to be careful.
Yeah.
I think that, I mean, we've just had 14 cases diagnosed in Melbourne just now, coming out of a private psychiatric institution. So that's going to really bump up our state's case load. So we can't be stupid about this, and we've still got to maintain social distancing and PPE. But I think we can certainly look at opening for certain things. And what we've decided is, we haven't set a date for this yet, but what we will do is allow the medical personnel to come back and do the medical treatments. And we'll wait until we have some more relaxation of our restrictions before we invite the dermal therapists back on board.
Yeah,
and if we do start, there's a whole heap of PPE that we're going to be putting in place, hand washing, hand hygiene, social distancing. So it's going to be a difficult space to navigate.
So let's get over to Katerra, Flawless.
Yeah. Oh, I'm excited.
Tell me what Katerra systems you have.
So I have 2 XLVs, which are basically the workhorse of our practice. You know, great machines. I enjoy using them both. They're great fun machines to use, and they produce results, which, you know, you can't argue with that.
Why did you choose Katerra in the first place? There were plenty of other systems out
there. They were the gold standard. There were 2 vascular machines on the market when I started. It was, I'll name names. There was the V-Beam, which I'd used, and I really liked that machine. And then there was the XLV. And I just felt the XLV was a slightly better machine that was slightly easier to use with less consumables and better support from Qterra. So I chose that one over the V-Beam, and I'm very glad that I did, because I say Qterra and what they're doing in the future and what's going to be happening this year is really excited, and I'm very, very excited to be on board and looking forward to the new machines coming.
So what's your favorite treatment to perform on the XLV?
What's my favorite treatment and what the clinic's favorite treatment are 2 different things. My favorite treatment is to deal with vascularity and vascular treatments, because I like to see that vessel just disappear and not come back. And it's a very satisfying procedure, and it's almost like playing the PlayStation when you're trying to get rid of vessels. So that's a great treatment. That's a lot of fun for me. But what is the most popular in our clinic is hands down laser genesis for our clients. And I say that machine is nonstop laser genesising. I don't know what the plural for that would be, but yeah, nonstop doing laser genesis. Hashtag laser genesis. Yeah, so that's basically the most popular treatment in the clinic by far.
It's totally my favorite.
When it comes to energy-based devices.
So I'm going to change it up a bit. I'm going to ask you something fun. What are you watching on Netflix? Anything else?
We watched The Tiger King.
I haven't seen it yet.
It's a train wreck. It's worth a watch, but yeah, you need a couple of wine to watch it. And what my wife and I have been enjoying is two comedy shows. One is Schitt's Creek.
Oh yes,
that's hilarious. So we've got about a season and a half to go on that. And then the other thing that was just hilarious, and it's a really short. There's only 7 episodes on catch up at the moment. I think not Netflix. It's on Foxtel. Is a show called Breeders. It's a UK comedy show, and it's
Breeders.
Really funny.
I'm writing this down. Breeders.
The first one is just hilarious, and if you've got kids, it's just a very funny, well written show.
That's hilarious. Are you a cook? Are you a cook by any means?
Not by any means, but I've had a crack at. So my wife's birthday was in lockdown. And she had been banging on about this dish that she wanted, which is from a restaurant in Melbourne. Luckily that my friend owns that restaurant. So I rang him up and said, my wife really wants this Moreton Bay bug linguine for a birthday. So he got his chef to make it for me, package it all up, and sent me instructions on how to create this dish. So it was basically heating it up. And so I managed to make my wife's favorite dish for her on her birthday. So, but as far as cooking goes, I'm great with the microwave. I'm a microwave expert. 3 minutes in the microwave, no problem. But the other cooking stuff, I'll leave to the experts like you.
I'm not an expert, just amateur, and I'm running out of ideas. It's my birthday next weekend, so I'm going to have an ISO birthday too. It's totally crazy.
No, look, it's one you're going to never forget. So we made it fun. And there were about 9 or 10 of Beck's friends that said at 10 o'clock, get her out the front of the house. And they all did this drive-by and gave her presents and played music and beat the horns and threw streamers. So it was different. But she will never forget her COVID-19 birthday.
That's very sweet of all her girlfriends to do that. So what are you doing to engage with your patients during COVID-19?
So what we're trying to focus on is what you can do at home. Mm-hmm. So if you look at our Instagram feed, we are not doing any energy-based device posts. We're not doing anything about injectables, or we're really concentrating on what you can do at home, because that's probably what you're going to be interested in. We've put together a couple of really easy skincare treatments that you can do at home, and they're really cheap, and we post them out to you, and then you watch the Instagram video of how to use all the products that are in that kit. Posting the odd video, just to try and keep in touch.
I follow you. I know. What about the staff? How have you been able to look after them and encourage them?
Well, the government have been really good. I've got to say the government have done an excellent job. The job keeper payments that they've offered have been amazing. So all our staff are still employed. Most of them are on the job keeper package, so they're still getting paid. Some of them are getting paid more than I used to pay them with the job keeper package, but I mean, that's the way it goes. And obviously we try and keep in touch with them as much as we can, and phone calls and texts, and try and keep them motivated, and hopefully they're staying well and isolating themselves.
That's great. For someone that was interested into getting into labels or any technology in their practice, why would you suggest Kateris XLV?
If you were starting out, I probably wouldn't go with the XLV.
Mm-hmm. What would you do?
I would go with the Zio. If you're just starting out, because it's such a versatile platform that you can do so many different treatments with that modality, and it's also expandable, so you can start with a basic CO and then you can build it up as you build up your confidence with other treatments, so you're not shelling out hundreds of thousands of dollars on an XLV. But when you cut your teeth, then the XLV is the next place to go. But if you were an experienced physician and you'd had a few years behind yourself, then number one would be XLV for me.
If you could invest in the next big aesthetic technology to come into practice, what would it
be? Which I'm going to do. You know the answer to this. And hopefully the offer still stands from Brett. I have the paperwork there. We just need to sign it. So we're just waiting for it to let us know when you can bring one in. And that's going to be the TruSculpt Flex.
Oh,
that's
nothing
for me. I
can't wait. Can I tell you that when COVID started, I had one delivered to the place, to my house. I am coming out of this looking better than ever. So watch this space.
Oh, you know, look here, this is my living room. Well, one of the living rooms. Look what I've managed to get out of the practice.
Oh, perfect.
So the girls are beside themselves. Every night one of them's on the LED. So yeah,
we've managed. That's why you look so good, because COVID suits you. COVID suits you, totally.
All right.
So is there anyone you would go on.
Yeah, the Flex. I'm really excited about the Flex. I want to be the first one in Australia. We're ready to go, and we've got loads of people lined up that I've shown the presentation that you presented at Kitchener University, and these guys are they want to book time now.
Oh, fantastic. It's a game changer. It's a total game changer. I love
absolutely.
It. I absolutely love it. Is there anyone in the industry that you admire?
There are heaps of people in the industry I admire. Obviously, Greg Goodman, who has been a mentor to me for a number of years, and he's just a very generous man, and from a knowledge perspective, and been very supportive of me. What's that?
That's where I first met you.
That's exactly where you first met me. And then we've got some amazing, we've got some amazing physicians in Australia. You've got Stephen Liu, you've got Mark Magnuson. These guys are just brilliant to listen to. Steph Roberts also springs to mind. She's taught me so much in my career and been very supportive. There were so many people that you can learn so much from. And we have so much great talent within Australia that I don't think we always like to get the international guys over. They're always good, but we've got so much local talent that we need to draw on a little more.
Yeah, what I love is everyone's so supportive of each other. Everyone loves to share the knowledge together. It's a really lovely
thing. Yeah, that's the way it should be.
Yeah. Is there anything that estheticians or doctors do in this industry that really annoys you?
There are lots of things that people do that annoy me, but obviously the thing that I think that annoys a lot of other people is let's just look at laser hair removal for one. So laser hair removal was a great, easy, fairly lucrative part of people's business. And over the last 10 years, we've just seen that been bastardized to the point that even the companies that have gone down that path and that have reduced the price of that modality are struggling, because everyone's had laser hair removal and there's no point in getting it there's no point in paying for a deal today, because tomorrow there's going to be a cheaper deal from somebody else. So I've seen that, and I see some other treatments going that way too.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
What kind of ideas do you have for business that will help you rebuild?
That will help me?
Rebuild.
Number one is to open. If we can get open, then I get rung almost on a daily basis asking us when we're going to open, what's going on. Our feed is constantly people, we're waiting for you guys to open. So we just need to open, and we just need to dig us out of this hole that we're in. And it's going to take a little while for us to get back to where we were before, because I think we built up some momentum. I think lots of businesses were doing well this year, and we're just been put behind the eight ball again.
Is there any kind of support you'd like from me or Katera during this period now, or even when COVID restrictions are lifted?
Yeah. Can you get me, can I have your ID flex? Post it down to me.
I can't commit.
No, look, I think from Qtera, I think Qtera's done very well. I've liked the webinars and stuff that have been happening. And that's basically what it is. Now's a great time for education and to take a step back and have time as a business owner to look at your business, to look at what was going well, to look at what's not working so well, and just have the time to look at how you're going to move forward. And I think some of the material I've seen come out of Qtera has been very useful, and a lot of the business stuff I've read and I've found quite interesting, and the webinars as well. So it's great time to upskill.
Now, we had a customer appreciation week last week, and you were the grand prize winner of Qtera. Do you not know that?
I didn't know that at all.
You were the grand prize winner. And so you have $500 to spend on my Qtera for laser goggles or, you know, whatever you might want. I'm sorry, awesome. Someone has informed you.
Oh, no, well, that's great. I'm very happy with that, and we'll definitely spend it with Qtera, and that's going to be awesome.
That's excellent. Is there anything you'd like to say to your clients and or the industry right now?
We've got to support each other, and we've got to stick together, and we've got to do the right thing, and we will get through this, but we need to be kind to each other. And unfortunately, and I think you've probably seen the same on social media, there have been some not flattering comments by some people made against some people. And I think that we kind of just need to be kind, and we need to support each other through this, because everyone else is going through the same thing, and some people deal with it in different ways. But at the end of the day, we'll recover, we'll get through this, and we'll be a stronger industry afterwards. But we need to be kind.
Nice. Okay, but last but not least, do you know any funny jokes?
Yeah, I need to ask this. Man, all the jokes I know are filthy.
Why does that not surprise me?
Probably not the forum, but yeah.
Okay, when I finish recording, you can tell me.
Yeah, your ears will burn.
Thanks for having a coffee with me.
Yeah, oh, pleasure. I'll get my, I'm drinking water at the moment because
it's so enough day, so I can't get my coffee. It's so good to see you. Hopefully we can have a real coffee soon.
Yeah, well, hopefully. Yeah, coffee, something else.
Okay, glass of wine. Well, I said it.
That's it. We'll have a glass of wine next time we see. But yeah, look, I'm just hopefully we can all get together soon.
Next time I see you, it will be for flex training. Don't you worry.
Oh, it's on. Let's go. I'm ready. I need some true sculpt before my flex, though.
Well, you might need to get a combo.
Yeah, I've got the paperwork on a combo too, but yeah, geez, we'll just see how we go with that.
We're relentless. It's all about you. It's all about you.
Of course. Okay. I'll see you later.
Thanks so much, Sean. Great to see you.
Bye.
Bye.